The reigning Pac-12 Tournament champs go back-to-back. A wonderful moment for Anna Wilson, Tara Vanderveer, and this fantastic squad. As Tara said, there are no bad days when you have Lexie and Lacie Hull on your team. The twins, the Hull sisters, joining us on set now. Congratulations to you both. You both have just been so awesome to watch over your four years at Stanford. And I'm a little bit sad that this is potentially the last Pac-12 Tournament we're going to see you in. But I just have to say, to be able to go out with Anna Wilson and some of the depth that you guys have on this roster and to be able to win it in your last one, what does it mean to you?
Super special. I mean, we talked about this at the beginning of the season. This is one of our goals, one of the things we want to check off, and to be able to do that with this group, it's super special.
Lacie, I want to talk to you because I am so impressed, and I have always been impressed with you. First year you worked out with the post, which is hard to imagine now, and you start a bunch of games, and then in this offseason Tara's like, I need you to try a whole new position and play point. You've started 29 games this year. Talk about your journey and what that journey and that hard work's meant for you.
I mean, it's definitely been a transition. I'm lucky to have been under. I got to see Kiana do such a tremendous job the last 3 years, so it wasn't hard to find someone to try and emulate. But I think over my time here, I've just been trying to fill gaps where the team needs me, and this year that's where it is. We're lucky with Tara and Kate and Brittany and Katie with coaches that really prepare us well. So I think I've been surrounded by what is like the best scenario to learn a new position in.
You know, you guys have such a special story to be able to hoop at the most elite levels as sisters, as twins. For each of you, would love to hear you say what you're most proud of Lexie and what you're most proud of Lacie as you sit here in this moment.
I think just going back off of her filling every role, I mean, she's done everything for our team. I think it's just that. She's ready to do whatever it takes for the team and do the job that needs to be done. And super, super happy and lucky to be able to play with her every day. But it's crazy that it's coming to an end.
Oh, no.
Associate head coach.
I'm really proud of Lexie. Day in, day out, she's someone we can count on to get stops, to get points. She's dependable and brings a lot of leadership to our team, and we're really lucky. And I'm really lucky to have gone through all of this with her.
So. You guys, the difference between a year ago where we had pictures of your dogs instead of fans, and every day you'd walk out and see your two dogs and then go play a game in Santa Cruz, and this year, the Stanford, I've never seen more Stanford people in the house ever. What was this environment like for you guys?
We definitely felt the support. Stanford's been traveling so well. We feel the love, especially playing in Maples, not having been able to do that last year. It's been incredible, and we love every single fan. We love seeing fans. It's amazing.
Okay, so I feel like every season we celebrate Tara Vanderveer being excellent. And last year it was becoming the all-time leading winner, most winningest coach in women's college basketball history. And I think today it's now her 1,001th. Is that the way you say that?
I think that sounds right to me.
Tara just got her 1,001 win at Stanford. I mean, can you just talk about being coached by someone so great at their craft?
I mean, I think the thing that's pretty crazy, she continues to surprise us. Her halftime talks, her pregame talks continue to hype us up, get us ready, and it's a joy to play for her and continue to learn from her every day.
This tournament, the coaching staff have been in such incredible moods, so positive, so happy, and I think that's carried over to today.
Tara's halftime and post-game speeches, they get you guys riled up pregame?
Yeah.
She's quite funny, actually.
She is. She gets us laughing for sure, and she told us before the tournament started that she wanted to have a shower at the end. So we're going to give her a shower when we get back.
That's good. Yeah. As you should.
Can someone get pictures? Make sure there's
a camera. We'll get the cameras out.
Just try not to mess her hair up too much. I know how she is about that.
I already got messed up early. I don't know if you saw that.
You guys put the hat on her backwards.
Yeah. That was one of my favorite moments of the trophies presentation, by the way.
That's T-Dog in that moment? Mm-hmm. Okay.
We say that's her best look, is the hat backwards look. So hopefully we can get more of those.
They had Jordan Hamilton do it, too.
So okay.
That was smart. Before we let you guys go, we talk so much about what excellent basketball players you are, but you just won Pac-12 Scholar Athlete of the Year, Lexie, and I just think about what both of you have done in the classroom at Stanford University. Can you just reflect on your journey, what it's meant to be playing for this program, but to be able to earn your degrees from Stanford and do it at such a high level?
I think that was one of the big reasons for coming here together is
we knew that Stanford was the best on the court and off the court, and to be able to learn in an incredible classroom with incredible classmates, I mean, we're learning in every aspect of school, so super lucky to be here.
It has been a joy to watch both of you play. Thank you for joining us. I know you got a shower to give, so yeah. I'll let you go, Dallas, Tara. And hey, it's not over yet. Still six more games. We're hoping that you get to play together in a Stanford uniform. Best of luck in the NCAA
tournament. Thank you so much.
Congrats, ladies.